share is geared towards achieving sustainable food security through increased productivity and value chain addition on indigenous agricultural products for a healthy nation, as well as improved environmental conservation.
I'm George Oluoch of Kenya Highland Seed, but we commonly use our brand, which is Royal Seed. We've developed some varieties that are very resistant to bacterial wilt, or rather tolerant. For example, on tomatoes we have, for open field, we have Rambo F1, which is a hybrid, which is very much tolerant to bacterial wilt. And then when we go to greenhouse, because technology is also evolving so fast, on the greenhouse products we have Samantha, which is also very tolerant to bacterial wilt. So those are some of the technologies that we have, and we already have them, we've already rolled out with the farmers, because we are doing demonstrations with so many farmers all over the country. We've had a number of challenges with the farmers, mostly with the diseases. For example, bacterial wilt, which is a menace in most parts of this country. We have vegetables. I'll start right from where we are. We have a number of cabbages. We have Pretoria F1, which, as you can see, it's doing so well, and seeing is believing. You can see and believe it for yourself. And we also have Fabiola F1, which you can, the farmers can also visit and see. We have a number of leafy vegetables as well. We have spinach, Fodouk giant, but raw seed specifically. And then we have kale, thousand-headed, commonly. And then we have the sukuma wiki that you can see right behind me. And then we have tomatoes. We have open pollinated varieties like Oxley. And then we have hybrids, Rambo F1, which I said earlier on, that is resistant to bacterial wilt.
My name is Jaap Mazee, and I'm working for HZPC. That's the seed potato company from Holland. I see the varieties that you grow here. They are very strong. They are resistant against diseases like blight. And in Europe, it's not such a big fight against blight, because we can use chemicals, and the climate is different. Comparing with Holland, we can plant in Holland only one time per year potatoes. Only during the summer. In the spring we plant, in the autumn we lift. Then the winter starts. But over here it's unbelievable. You can plant in this beautiful soil three times per year, almost year round, potatoes.
Is a multinational company, and our focus is vegetable seeds, and we're also doing crop protection. We are trying to showcase new technologies to farmers in terms of seed. We want farmers to adopt the hybrid varieties, and also to understand their crop in terms of disease and pest management.
My name is Robert Musyoki from Simlo Seed Company. Simlo Seed is one of the subsidiary companies of Kenya Seed. Simlo Seed handles more of the vegetables and legumes, while Kenya Seed handles maize, sunflower, wheat, sorghum, grain grain crop cereals. That's what Kenya Seed handles. Simlaw Seed is moving or taking agriculture to higher notch, whereby it's introducing the hybrids, and these hybrids, why we are having hybrids or why the whole world is moving towards the hybrid is because, one, they grow very fast, they are uniform, you get uniform products, and of course the products are resistant to many diseases and pests that are really now common in this region. And of course the yields are far much better, are far much higher, and of course the market quality, such that when the products you take it to the quality, of course every buyer would want to have that that product because of the quality. So Simlaw Seed actually is moving from what we are used to call, what we are calling open pollinated products, to hybrids because of the high value. That is, we want to improve on production per unit area, whereby in the normal circumstances, whereby per square meter you are likely to get 10 cabbages, but which maybe each of them normally weighing a kilo, 2 kilos. Here we have cabbages that are compact, uniform in growth, and of course they mature very fast.
My name is Nelson Kemei from Juango. I'm a business development manager in charge of Northrift. As Juango, we have so many products of wheat and barley. And as you can see on our demo plots, we've used our products for the herbicides. We've used Aurora Turbo, that is for the herbicides, both wheat and barley. And for insecticide, we've used Brigade, that is for the Russian aphid. And for the bollworm, we've used Marshall. As you can see, these are the most challenges that the farmers are encountering in this region. Yeah, so the bollworms usually get into the stem, so it's very difficult to control. So we've used the Marshall. So as for the foliar fertilizers, we have Synergizer. Synergizer is very good. As you can see, it's very green. If you look across on the other side, you know, there is a clear difference when you use Synergizer, our products, Juango products. So we really believe in technology, good technology that's coming in, and our product is always moving. And in the next few months, we're going to launch a fungicide for the wheat, so that we can give the farmers the best produce that they can get from Juango. We have a range of farmers whom they trust our products. Our product is of the best quality in this market. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and we are proud of that, and we're continuing to bring in more products that are more technologically advanced. Mm-hmm. These are for these guys to come up with a drought resistant wheat, mm-hmm, and barley, because this year was very challenging. We've had a lot of drought in this region. So if we can have a wheat that is drought resistant, I think we can move forward. If you need to increase production, you don't increase the size of land so that you can increase production. You have to use technology so that you can get more. So if you invest in technology, like now this one, you get drought tolerant, disease tolerant, high yielding, then now you're going to increase your production.
My name is Violet Mlanda. I'm from the School of Agriculture and Biotechnology, Department of Seed, Crop and Horticultural Sciences, where we do courses like seed science and technology, general agriculture, and horticulture. Because we are an agricultural department, we do encourage farmers to go indigenous. That is why we are working on indigenous vegetables like cowpeas, spider plant and black nightshade. And we also have the African spinach, which is commonly known as nderema. It's a very good vegetable because its iron content is high as compared to the exotic vegetables like sukuma wiki. That's why we are encouraging farmers to use the indigenous vegetables. And also the indigenous vegetables like the African spinach I've talked about, it can grow under dry seasons where it requires just a little amount of water, unlike the sukuma wiki and the cabbages that require high amounts of water. The farmers are really appreciating this because this trade fair has been going on for a very long time, and we do get a very good number of farmers. I can say 99% because they do come in large numbers.
My name is Kibet Kilbalangat. I'm from School of Engineering and Department of Agricultural and Biosystems Engineering. As a student, outgoing student, and I came up with a solar tracking system that will be able to assist the farmer in drying the products, agricultural products. So for this case, I used the solar concentrator that will be able to capture much of the energy from the sun that will actually be able to dry the products. Also, I'm in the design phase of the system that is automating the system so that at the end of the day, it will be able to follow the sun from morning to evening, and that will create a lot of efficiencies for the system. So the major challenge maybe that I have now is to develop the prototype of the same. If there will be any support, and then I will appreciate and be able to make a system that will be able to assist a farmer and will be able to be effective, especially in trying the products to increase the shelf life, and in which a farmer can be able to store the product for a very long time, for the value addition.
Some of the technologies are in terms of crop production techniques, in terms of fertilizer use, in terms of different varieties of seed that are used. And this year specifically, I found out that farmers were so excited about some of the vegetable crops here, and they were actually wondering whether they can actually do well here in this region. And therefore we are excited, and we tell them that it is possible, so they have to know all the technologies that take place.
My name is Calvin Mosot Nyaveri. I'm a field officer with the Sidico Kenya Limited. And in Sidico, we involve ourselves with the production, breeding, and marketing of high quality seeds. We deal with the cereals, that is maize, sorghum. We also deal with the soybeans. We also handle a number of vegetable seeds. In the seed call, we ask ourselves, when the farmer is looking for maize seed to go and plant, what is he looking for? And we negate that the farmer is looking for a seed which can be able to yield properly. That's why we have brands like Tembo 73, which can give you up to 58 bags per acre. Then we also know that the farmer is looking for a variety which will be drought tolerant. And that's why we have Pundamiria 53, which is very drought tolerant. We have also have Simba, which can tolerate heat. And we also know that the farmers also look for varieties which can resist diseases. And for that matter, we have varieties which resist various diseases, semi-strike failures, grey leaf spot, and the likes. About the technology, we have field officers and field assistants based all over the country. We have a very able research team working around the crop to ensure that we have the varieties needed, and we have communicated this information to the farmers, and the farmers know per region and by altitude which varieties they can be able to do, and the varieties compete competitively with along the other existing varieties. And you will see several farmers are adopting and embracing our various brands.
I'm Wilson Serone, working for Panacid in Eldoret as a sales rep for Panacid in the North Rift region. In seed business, we do maize seed or varieties. We have seed for all the altitudes, all the agroecological zones, from the low altitude all the way to what we call the highland varieties, which we grow here in basically in the North Rift. We are also in the dairy subsector, we are in sunflower, we're doing sunflower, and we're also introducing some products, some forage material. We're bringing in Silage King, which is a product that we bring into the market for those who are doing silage, a variety that you can plant and harvest two or three times a year, good for silage. But we have quite a number of varieties for maize. We have our early maturing variety called 4M21, which matures in 3 months. We have Pan 67 that matures in 3.5 months, with a yield potential between 30 and 35. We have a new product that we are bringing into this market, good for silage again, that takes 3 months. It's called 3.5 months to four. It's called Pan 15. For now, we are doing over 70% of the large scale, the commercial farmers. 70% of the commercial farmers. We're now going into the small scale farmers, which we really appreciate the reports that we are getting today for those who bought this year. And we're seeing the business grow in terms of the responses we're getting from the farmers and those who planted this year. The results that we are getting is impressive. The challenge in this market now is the new diseases. We have MNLD in the market now, a new disease that's quite a challenge. But we believe the research guys are doing something, because that is the main challenge now in the seed subsector.
My name is Rebecca Wanyonyi. I'm from ADC, Kitale. Okay, we are having this new variety of seed called KH623A. So far, it's the high yielding on the market. Okay, giving us a minimum of 43 to 68 bags per hectare, but under good management. Okay, we came up with this type of seed because currently we are having the problem of population increase, and we want farmers to increase their production per hectare. Unona. Then because of diseases, we want them to reduce. So that is why we are telling them to plant this variety. Because if you plant it per hectare, you will get high yield, and you plant once. So that during the second season, you do an alternative crop to reduce the perception or the probability of it, of maize being affected with MNLD and other diseases.
My name is Javan Okango from ADC Molo. At ADC Molo, we are mostly specifically for seed potato multiplication. There at our ADC Molo, we have a plant there, a cold store plant, which can cover up to 1,550 metric tons of potatoes. There at Molo, we have established a tissue culture lab which enables us to multiply seed potatoes in a very quick way so that it can reach farmers when it's still in a high status material. We are having about five farmers who are doing for multiplying for ADC. Some of the outgrowers, if you give him maybe a potato crop, he, when harvesting, he sometimes removes and sell them to the open market, which is a loss of seed production, seed potatoes.
I am working under this project, stem rust project, which deals with delicose, of which delicose is the leguminous plants under the papyrus leguminous, which have totally generally beans. So we had to come up with the forefathers of the beans, this delicose, which is katumani from the Kenya seed, and work with it under what we call research. Then we had to come up with many results against the katumani after doing those research and taking it through mutation and plant breeding. The disadvantages first of it, they are being affected by late blight and early blight. At the same time, the weather condition, whether the places we used to plant, because it needs hot and wet areas, not with cold season like this Uasin Gishu area. So the advantages is the seed itself has a lot of iron, it has a lot of protein and calcium. Some of these varieties that were released are among those which we are displaying in our site here. This is Eldo Baraka. We have also Eldo Mafuno, which is actually good for the farmers in Uasin Gishu. So these are some of the list varieties that are good. They have some good cut, which some of our farmers in Uasin Gishu can take when the institution will have had adequate seed after multiplying from basic seed so that they can give to the farmers for production as commercial. We hope very soon all this seed that we are talking of, Eldo Mafuno and Eldo Baraka, will be available for the farmers so that they can utilize, because it has very unique characters like stem rust resistance and can help our farmers. The breeders from where they are undertaking these kinds of breeding, I think they are facing some challenges because maybe finance and getting sponsors to fund them so that they can get also some more varieties could be some of the challenges they are facing.
The Cherop. I'm working with Timac company, that is Timac Agro fertilizer, that deals with the fertilizer that has some elements that we lack in our common fertilizer. This fertilizer is so much useful to our farmers in that we've got the sulfamo, locustat and physiolith, which it has calcium. Calcium helps acts as a lime, and lime reduces the acidity. The gold fertilizer that we are selling as Timac, it has boron and molybdenum. Boron helps the crops in, for example, cabbages in filling, the head filling. It helps in head filling and also molybdenum in the test, in adding that sweet test in our crops. The challenges that we are facing on this technology is that we are just working with fertilizers, but any kind of chemical that is the chemical that can be used as to treat some pests and diseases, we have not yet invented yet. So we depend with the Syngenta company to give us some chemicals to take care of our crops in case of any attack, maybe pest attack. We depend on Syngenta so that they can give us or they can boost us on the giving those chemicals.
My name is Betty Musembi. I work for a company called Timac Agro. It's a subsidiary of Timac International, which is a French company, which is part of Group Hulia International. We deal with plant nutrition. We are dealing with special fertilizer, mainly to address soil fertility and nutrient uptake, and the challenges that we've been having with the normal conventional fertilizers that are acidifying. We have a granular fertilizer, and all our fertilizers are based on all non-acidifying fertilizers, and the main element that we are including in the fertilizer is calcium. Calcium is like the cement of soil. It helps hold the nutrients together for the crop. So we have included in every fertilizer, we have included that element in our top dressing fertilizer, in our planting fertilizer, we have it. And we also have granular lime, which is extracted from the sea in France. It's a granular lime, very soluble, as opposed to the normal terrestrial lime that farmers have been using, which is very bulky, and sometimes the farmers will need a lot for it to have effect. Then also, because of the dissolving is very low, the dissolving capacity is very low, so the farmers will see maybe the effect after a very long time. What we have now is instant. You see results instantly. You apply in this season and you see results in this season. And it's very easy to apply because it's a granular as opposed to the powder form. Our farmers have been using these acidifying fertilizers and the pH has gone really low and the elements are no longer available to the crop. That has seen the increase in quantities of use of fertilizer to our farmers, which is also increasing the cost of inputs for our farmers. So what we intend to do, we come in with this technology, we try to transform our farmers, we try to transform our soils, we make our soils healthier, and that way we are able to reduce even on the cost of input. Most of them are really receptive of the technology. I am not able to really quantify how many as at the moment that we have on board, but we have quite a good number. The challenges that we've been facing is that most farmers are a bit rigid. They still want to use the conventional fertilizer, and the cost also has gone a bit higher because of its special technology. So much techniques and so much time and research and development has gone into it. So also the cost gets a bit higher. But if farmers are able to embrace this technology, they will be able to reap the benefits later on.
Charles Sultan. I'm working with Ultravetis East Africa Company Limited. About our technology that is now improvising and creating innovative animal health products, farmers have really proven that our products are the best because they give a solution to the farmers. That's why the farmers keep on asking our products wherever they are. These products, we have got very many farmers all over the country and even outside the country. Because they like our products. Our products provide the. We normally say that our value is to provide innovative animal health solution, provide quality products that give results to the farmers. It's really very simple to the farmer. They like it. They are being impressed with it because it doesn't mean that they need to have it on or with their eyes. It is just a thermostable, which is now the current technology that farmers have.
name is Moses Pierre. I'm from Moro Research. Now, I'm a plant breeder by profession. I'm here to represent Paredram and other industrial crops directorate. The technology has been embraced by farmers over 99%. But after maybe 3 years back, there has been some decline due to some logistical issues, but farmers are still having the crop and they have the spirit and the passion for the crop. That is why we are coming back to entice the farmers to go back to the crop, because the gross margin of Paredram is higher than tea and coffee. We have advantage of the biotechnology we embrace, because one thing is disease free, which can cut close the cost of disease control and pest control. The crops, you get more quantity of the crop per given time, and the crop is normally vigorous per time. Some years back, we've been having some decline in production of the crop from our growers. I think it's due to logistical issues and political issues. I don't want to interfere with that. Mine is just technical. I don't have to intervene in that. Now the former Paredram Board of Kenya is now at the AFA, one of the directorates. We have our mission, vision and objectives. And one of them is to sustain the farmer and to give the farmer a good, superior crop, Paredram, which can be grown in this region and which can at least uplift the level of standard of living of a farmer and to eradicate poverty levels in the country.
Christopher Namare Luyo, the area sales manager, Elgon Kenya, dealing with fertilizers. Elgon Kenya Limited is a company, agrochemical company, dealing with fertilizers. And we also deal with chemicals, supplying chemicals all over Kenya. The new technology that we have in place is that most of the farms around have a problem with the acidity in their soil. And we have partnered with some of the company dealing with the testing, so that when we give out the fertilizers, the soil had actually been tested, so that actually when you plant, you get the best result. We have got about 10,000 serious farmers who are using this technology, and we are expecting that many will join us and actually have the best technology around from Elgon Kenya Limited. The advantage of the new technology is that it has boosted the production of crops. You have a lot of production in the maize, beans, and we are urging all farmers actually to embrace the technology so that we could have enough food in the country. Most of the farmers have embraced the, since it's a pioneer movement, we have not got a lot of challenges from farmers. We are doing a lot of marketing all around the country so that we can capture a lot of farmers around.
Martin Turere. I'm an agribusiness agronomist at Amiran, Kenya. Mostly we're doing the greenhouses for big companies. The flower industry that has really developed and has really made a name for us. We were pioneers in that department. Then that was the major thing that was selling us. Thereafter we delved into chemicals, because for the flower you need the chemicals to fight the diseases and the pests. So we are trying to curtail the issue of growing it in open field, where you do large tracts of land and get minimal returns in terms of using too much chemical to control pests, and even exposing your crop to the vagaries of weather. I cannot pinpoint the exact number, but in terms of percentage, 75% of Kenya is under small-scale greenhouses. Amiran greenhouses. Advantages is that you can, with the issue of land is becoming small, and soon you're going to have more conflicts about land. And having a small piece of land where you can produce a lot over a time span of a year or so is quite the way, is the advantage, is the benefit of this one.
The ministry will work very closely with this university so that we use it in terms of it's passing knowledge to farmers in terms of value addition. So we will sit down and agree what kind of value addition products we will be able to work together with. Yeah, so that we use this institution to train not only our students but also farmers.
My name is Julius Onyango Chuma. I'm a professor of seed science, part of agriculture in this university. I've been teaching in this university for the last 19 years. That was after I left CARI, Seed Quality. The event that we've had here for the last 3 days is called Agribusiness Trade Fair. It was mooted some 4 years ago to try and bring farmers together with agro dealers, those people who sell tractors, and the university fraternity, so that there can be an interrelationship between the three people. It is important that these three people can be able to understand each other so that we can develop the right technologies. The technology that the farmer needs, the technology that answers the problems of the farmer. At the same time, we bring in industry, because industry also is trying to do things for the farmers, but they need information and they can only get it from the university. So we have this tripartite kind of arrangement, and that is what makes this show. The university has several technologies that they are showing. For example, now we have the barley research project, where we are showing the various barley varieties, the various fertilizers that are used for growing barley. Because this is a project that we are doing for the East African breweries, we are actually undertaking all the crop development aspects for breweries. So this is a good example of university-industry linkage. On the wheat, 2 years ago we developed two varieties of wheat that are tolerant. One is tolerant, another one is resistant to rust, to stem rust, called UG99, which is causing a lot of problems in wheat. Now it has even moved to barley. It was initially in wheat, but now it is also in barley. So that is the technology that we are showing there. Most of the maize is not our work. It is work from CARI. It is work from Kenya Seed, it is work from PANA and other international seed companies like Pioneer. They are here also to show the technologies that they have today, because we have issues with maize production, especially. The maize necrotic lethal disease, which is a problem in this area. And also Southern Rift Valley. It is causing a lot of problems, and we've not yet gotten a way of controlling it. Of course, the government is saying that we do rotations, that we undertake the cultivation of other crops. That is one way of doing it, but the most important way is to develop a variety that can be able to tolerate this particular disease. And there are some technologies that are being shown in that line. that is maize, necrotic lethal disease. But there are also several other biotic and abiotic stresses, like drought, like striga. All those are being demonstrated there. The horticulture, we have the vegetables. These are basically being shown the new varieties of tomatoes, cabbages. But a new entrant to this show is the potato value chain from the Netherlands. They have come in a big way. They have actually brought in the whole potato value chain from plowing, planting, weeding, to harvesting of potatoes. They come here, they grow the various, last year they brought 15 varieties of potatoes. They are trying to maybe screen them around so that the farmers here can use the same potatoes. They are, of course, being sponsored by the Dutch Embassy in Nairobi. The university has an outreach program. They go to schools, they go to primary, secondary schools. We are also interacting with some of the farmer groups that are away from here. We take these same technologies to them. Presently, the university, together with SNV, which is a Dutch non-governmental organization, is developing an outreach center. This is a center that is going to have four important pillars. One would be outreach. That is a place where we are going to have information of the technologies that are available, the experts that are around, so such that when a farmer has a problem and they ring, we will tell them where and who can solve their problem. The other pillar would be a practical farmer training center. Chepkoelel was known as a large-scale farmer training center, where farmers used to come and be trained hands-on technology and information. That died when the university came here. We are going back to the same, to ensure that farmers can come here and be trained. And we want to start with horticulture, which we already have a center in collaboration with Syngenta, and then we are going to have dairy training center in collaboration with the SNV. The other part, the other pillar would be an incubation center. We want to have a place where people with ideas can come and incubate them into businesses, can incubate them into technologies, even students that have good ideas. Theses that have good ideas, we can upscale them so that we can find a way of having technologies that are developed go out and be of use to the farmers.